Hey, it's John from During Charm. I'm going to do a review, which will kind of be a two-part thing here, of this demolition hammer. Now, this is a Harbor Freight tool. They use this Bauer. It's kind of their house brand. And the model number is a 1643E-B. All right. It's kind of a mid-range in their demolition hammers. Now, right off the bat, before we get too far into this, I'm going to answer a question I know I'm going to get, which is, why are you buying Harbor Freight tools? Well, I'll answer that. As a general rule, I don't purchase electrical tools, saws and grinders and things like that from Harbor Freight. They're garbage. And it's not just that they're made in China, it's that they're made to be cheap. They're entry-level crap. However, sometimes rules are made to be broken. So the reason I went ahead with this is twofold. One, I'm a professional. I do a lot of bathroom and kitchen remodels, and I'm getting older and I'm really getting tired of chipping tile up from existing floors. You know, typically I'll chip a line of tile out to expose the plywood underneath or whatever's underneath, and then cut the floor into 2x2 sections or something like that and rip the whole thing up. But it's a lot of work to use a baby sledgehammer and a cold chisel by hand and break up that tile. So I thought finally I'd try a demolition hammer to see if I can make that work. It may not work, I don't know yet. But the cost of this was so cheap, $150, that if I can make this work for one job, it actually is worth it to me. So that was part one. The other part is that in general, the state of manufacturing in China has been improving over years and decades, actually. So even the low-end crap isn't quite as bad as it used to be. So for those two reasons, I decided to give this a try. All right, if we open up the box, this is what we get. Here's the main unit. Here's the business end. You got a handle here. This is typical. You loosen that handle, screw it in place where you want it. So that's just for your left hand, if you're right-handed. Trigger mechanism here. Nice big trigger there. And it's not a small unit, but for what it's trying to do here, you know, it takes some heft. So we'll look at that more in a minute. We also get, I think this is just a shield for protecting your hands, I guess. I'm not really sure why, honestly. I think the chisel shank goes right through that. Then you have a little tool here that they give you to remove the grease cup, I think. They give you a cup with some grease in it. And I'm told you can use almost any kind of grease. It's really not that critical. There's an extra pair of brushes, which kind of tells you something about this tool. It's going to eat up brushes, apparently. And they give you the booklet on instructions and all. As far as the specs, they have it right here on the outside of the box. 10.5 amps, so you should be able to run this on a regular outlet in a residential setting. Impact rate and energy, it gives you all this. The shank type is SDS Max. Now, they don't include any chisels or bits or anything, so I'll look at that in a second. Gives you a power cord of 7 foot, and it's 13, almost 14 pounds, so it's not light. All right, now, what they don't include are the chisels. Now, Harbor Freight had these for $49, which isn't cheap. I imagine that's where they're making their money. So they're giving me a smaller chisel, a larger one, and a pointed one. For me, I'll probably use one of these two flat ones for what I'm trying to do. So that's the general layout of what you get in the box. All right, just to look at some of the features of the unit itself. So up here is where the grease goes. That's why you have this special tool here. It has those pins coming down which engage those holes there to unscrew this. It's kind of a drag to have to be able to do it that way, but that's the way they did it. Here you have a selector knob, so you can do a chisel or drill, or hammer drill, I should say. As I showed you before, I mean, this trigger area here is there's my hand. It's fairly big, which is good for what you're trying to do here. And this handle on this side, you just loosen this, and then you can move it wherever you want to move it. Screw it back on, and you're good to go. All right, and then the inserting the chisels, I don't know if I can do this one-handed, I'll try. You just pull this back. Try to get that in focus, here we go. So you just pull this back, insert the chisel, let it slide up, and you're good to go there. So not much to it. and you know, the weight is not insubstantial. So this is for demolition. So if you're a lightweight and you know, you haven't had your Wheaties in the morning, you may have some trouble. All right, when I take this cap off, which is not very well machined, I must say, that's what you see inside there. And I actually was expecting something a little different, honestly. It's basically just a hole. The mechanical parts are inside there. And this cup that they give you, I guess it's just meant to measure the grease, but it's just kind of stupid. So basically, you just want to smudge a whole bunch of grease in there. They say to do it monthly. Well, I don't know what that means, because it depends on how much you're using this thing. But basically, you just want to keep this thing well greased in there. They give you this cup as a guide as far as how much. And I don't think the type of grease matters, as I said. But basically, it's just a hole, and there's some of the guts. All right, I got a quick demonstration up here on the shop floor, just to show you what this sounds like and everything plugged in. This is not a demonstration of its actual use, just kind of a quick idea of what it looks like. So if you don't have anything, if you're not doing anything with it, I've got the chisel in place here, but if you're just leaving it with no contact at the business end, it sounds like this. It's really no louder than a regular drill. Now, if I flip this selector switch to drill, you can see how that turns. Now, that's really, it's, you're not going to drill with this thing, I can tell you that. That's really just meant for turning, especially like if you have the pointed chisel, turning it as you're hammering. Now, it's, the hammer action is not going to happen until you press down on the business end. So I just have a block of wood here. Let me switch it back to regular hammer. All right. So nothing happens here, but if I push down on the business end, all right, so you get an idea, I'm not pushing very hard, of what that's going to be like. So, you know, on a piece of wood, it's not really going to do too much damage. But on masonry, you know, that hammering action should break up and be, I should be able to just push this thing along, and that's my hope. So, that's about all I can do here in the shop as far as explaining this thing. Now, my hope is to try this on a tile floor that's coming up probably in about a week. So I'll try this on demolition. If it works, I'm going to be a happy camper, because that'll save me a lot of time and save my tired old arms. Thank you. Right, so you saw some of the demonstrations of using this thing. The stuff on the wall, when you had tile on the wall board, I didn't really expect that to work, and it didn't work very well at all. So I would not recommend it for something like that. However, on the floor, in the shower, it really works surprisingly well. For $150, man, I would definitely suggest using something like this versus trying to do it by hand. It saved me at least half the time and certainly a lot of effort. Using this all day long is kind of like using a chainsaw all day long. If you ever had like a 22 or 24 inch chainsaw that you've done a lot of work with all day, you feel kind of the same way at the end of the day. Your forearms, your back are a little tired. It has a similar weight to that, but it's certainly much preferable than to try to do some of this work by hand. Now, the chisel that I used, I did not get at Harbor Freight. I think I bought this at Home Depot. It's made by Bosch, and it's designed for tile work. So it's got the SDS Max, fitment there. And the business end has this bend in it you see there, which allows you to get a little deeper into the work without hitting the tool. And I ended up grinding this edge to make it nice and sharp, and it really worked well. Not only did I use it for the tile, but I ended up having a mess with the plywood floor underneath the tile in this particular bath. It was quarter inch plywood that had been glued down to the floor, down to the subfloor. And if you've ever worked with something like that, you know it's just a royal bear to get up. So what I did was, I have a roofing tool that's meant to take off roofing shingles, and that's what I use to take up plywood. But getting that tool started is part of the battle. So I was able to use this demo hammer and this particular chisel just to get the edge of the plywood started up a little bit. And once I got it started up with this tool, because you can only go so deep with this, then I could use that roofing tool to get way underneath it and pry everything up. So this definitely helped in that too, which is not something I was expecting. So I definitely think this is worth the money. $150, you really can't go too far wrong. For me, this is a large bathroom, so it's 13 by 20, something like that. So it was worth it for me just for this one time. But I don't see any problems with the tool as far as long-term use. A lot of times with cheap tools, electric tools, you'll actually smell the wiring start to cook. I've had this anytime you use a really cheap tool. For the first time, it starts to get hot, whatever you're doing, and you can just smell that wire cooking, and you know it's not going to last very long. I did not get that with this tool. It seems really pretty good. Now, I haven't opened up the internals. It could be cheaper stuff in there. I don't really know, but I mean, just from the, I've gotten a day and a half of solid use out of this thing, and I don't see any problems. So with that in mind, I don't see any reason why this won't last at least for a few more jobs, and maybe for quite a while longer than that. So the end result, I'm going to call this a win for Harbor Freight. It's a 1643E-B, and I honestly, I'm sorry I didn't make this purchase earlier, because there's certainly other bathrooms I've done where getting the tile up off the floor was just a pain in the rear end. So I'm going to call this a win, and I would say if you're a homeowner, you know, and you're only doing one bath or one room, a kitchen or whatever, then, you know, maybe you think about it whether it's worth the money. If you're a pro or semi-pro, you do a lot of this work, yeah, I'd say this is a decent call for you. You might want to invest in a name brand with something a little heavier maybe if you're doing heavier work or whatever, but I think this is a serious option for you. I don't think you need to shy away from the Harbor Freight name or the Bauer name, say, you know, that's their house brand. I don't think you need to shy away from that in this particular case. Other tools I know are absolute crap, but this one seems pretty good.